operate makes you strong. Make the argument that that is not okay as an analogy by a president.
Well, look, first of all, it's simply not okay for any government official, nonetheless the president, to be urging people not to cooperate with a government investigation. And if you're not afraid of the results of those investigations, as it is, you would have even less reason to do that. But clearly here the president is saying, if you cross me, you're a rat, and implying we all know what happens to rats. But if you stand with me, truth or not, you're going to get taken care of. And I think, as others have said on this show already, that is clearly a case for obstruction of justice and witness tampering, as we saw earlier at different points with Michael Cohen when the president was calling him out as, you know, supporting him and being so strong and not wanting to say anything. This president is clearly feeling backed against a wall. We've heard all kinds of sources from the White House saying he's frantic as the noose is really getting tighter around this Russian investigation. And I think that's evidenced clearly in this tweet that no lawyer anywhere would ever feel comfortable with their client, even if they weren't the president of the United States, sending out.
Even if, Rick, let's say it has nothing to do with any suggestion that the president knows he did anything wrong. Put all that to the side. Wave it away. How do you feel about the president making these kinds of comparisons to who is good and who is bad?
Well, look, I don't see anything wrong with what he said about Roger Stone. I mean, Roger Stone came out and said, look, I'm not going to lie. There's nothing I would tell the special counsel that could be incriminating the president. If it was, I'd have to lie to do that. And I'm not going to lie. And the president says, good, don't lie.
Right. But that's not what they're asking him to do, right, Rick?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, and you're not arguing otherwise. But just to be clear, they're asking Roger Stone to come in and talk to them about what it was. And he's come in a little bit. They want more. And he says, well, I'm not going to flip on the president. Well played, Roger Stone. Well played. But if you think about it, Rick, part of his best defense here is that he is someone who's a little loose with the truth, right? Remember those days where the explanation of how Roger Stone knew all that stuff about WikiLeaks? It wasn't because he asked his friend Corsi to go ask somebody to ask into Assange. It's because he made it up. And that's what he did. He was playing. He was puffing. Remember that? And now he says, I would never say anything untrue. A little bit of mixed thoughts there.
Well, I think what he said is he's not, never said anything untrue under oath. I'm not going to stand here. I'm not going to stand here and say Roger Stone hasn't said anything that's untrue, because that would be untrue. And while I'm not in front of a grand jury, I'm in front of you, and I know
good
you'd
point,
hold me to
Rick.
That.
Good
so,
point.
So look, what Stone is saying is, I'm not going to say anything untrue to the grand jury. And what Trump is saying is, good for you.
Right.
I don't see that as a problem.
I don't have a problem with him lauding someone. But Christine, when it comes to Michael Cohen, he says that guy should get the book thrown at him.
Yeah.
So you have a president of the United States weighing in on what the sentence should be from someone who gave damaging testimony about him. We have never heard that before from
look,
a president.
And then
the difference becomes, if you look at it, it's not so much whether they were telling the truth. It's the content of their truth. Right. And in the case of Michael Cohen, he doesn't like the content of the truth because it is not helpful to him. In the case of Roger Stone, who says, which is curious phrasing, I'm not going to flip on the president, which implies you have something to flip on.
Right. Yeah. Roger is a tactician.
Oh, 100%.
He has done things and said things that are beyond disgusting. And he has been held out for those, and he should have been. But on this one, I get the game that he's playing, but he's not my concern.
Right.
I only have one president in this country, and that's the standard of behavior that we call out, not Roger Stone's standard of behavior.
And if you look at the president in this, he's made it clear over and over, even before, again, when he was saying different things about Michael Cohen, if you stay with me, whatever that means, I will be with you.
And sources around Cohen suggest the same, Rick. They say that in the beginning, there was a suggestion of a pardon out there, but it went away where Michael Cohen is involved. And now we have everybody running him down when they used to laud him, to use the word of the moment. And, Rick, you heard the president say, you know, he got convicted of these things that have nothing to do with me. Where's he getting that from? What charge sheet is he reading? All of it has something to do with the president.
Yeah, it has something to do with the president, but doesn't have anything to do with the president necessarily doing something, you know, illegal. I mean, look, the whole campaign finance thing is
specious. Who's campaign finance? But who were they for? You think he was paying off those women for himself?
He could have been paying off. He could have been paying off women for a variety of reasons, including not wanting his family to know that information. So
there's lots of reasons.
I'm saying Michael Cohen paying off those women was done for the president, Rick. We agree on that, right?
I agree with stuff for the president. That doesn't mean it was illegal. And I think there's lots of question as to whether that, even if it's true, that you have, you can prove that the only intent of the
pleaded
president
guilty.
At the time, he pleaded guilty to a charge that I don't think you could have gotten a conviction had he not.
Why did he
plead
guilty? But he pleaded guilty
for a lot of reasons to a lot of crimes that be in order to not have to suffer the consequences of other things you
but
might
it
have
makes
done
you guilty.
That may have had nothing to do with Donald Trump.
It makes you guilty, and this is clearly something that related to the president and the payment that he was making on behalf of the president, which clearly ends up being
a loan. And he lied to Congress for the president. And I'll tell you something. If you want to reward people for not being a rat, this guy had a great chance to submarine the president, Rick. Michael Cohen could have said, yeah, I lied to Congress. And you know why? Trump told me to. That's why. He said, back me up, brother. And I said, okay, Mr. President, I will. He never did any of that.
No.
He didn't do what would have been best for him. What does that tell you?
Well, first off, you know, I'm sure the president didn't tell him to lie.
You're
to,
sure?
To, I'm sure the
You're
president...
You're 100%
not,
sure.
I can't imagine a president
of
the United
States,
even this president.
Oh, even this president.
But, no, I cannot imagine
you
this president
You don't know what he did
someone.
And what he didn't do.
Well, you don't
and
either,
if it came
Chris.
Out that
I mean,
he did, I guarantee
none of
you
us
would
know,
be shocked.
But I can't imagine that this
Come
president
on.
Would tell someone to lie. I mean, that would be... I mean, particularly given the
really?
Fact that, that... Yeah, I can't. No,
the
I'm
The man
not
lies
tell.
With alacrity. He lies when the truth is a better story for him. Rick, what are you talking about?
There's a difference between... Look, there's a difference between someone who, on occasion... does stretch the truth when it
Known
comes to his public
day
statements.
And night.
And there's a difference between doing that and lying when you can be prosecuted for that lie.
This
I mean, this lying under oath is a very different thing than political hyperbole and other exaggerations.
Maybe Rick has a point, Christine. That's why the president didn't want to testify in front of Mueller.
Exactly.
You know, other than his boast to Jonathan Carl, I can't wait to do it under oath.
Look, and Rick,
but he didn't do it, did he?
Rick, you would never tell your children it's okay to lie on these things, but not to lie when you're under oath. That's the only time you have to tell the truth. And
we
this president has shown that he is able and willing and consistently will lie in any way you define a lie. Venial or mortal sin, however you define it,
Uh-oh.
He is willing
She's
to do that.
She's coming Catholic on you, Rick.
I know.
She's coming Catholic
She's
on you.
It's going to get ugly,
She's
Rick.
She's coming into your wheelhouse.
Get it all the time on this show.
Not for me. I think I'm one of the few Catholics you got coming your way.
What I'm suggesting is no lie is a good thing, and I agree with you, Christine, on all that. But what the point we were discussing is whether the president would tell someone to lie under oath.
Of course.
And that is
would.
Very different than all the things that we've accused the president of, sometimes justifiably, in the last couple of years.
All right, fair enough. But here's what happens. So this is the main concern, Christine. I want to get a sense from both of you about this. This has been dismissed by the president and his supporters as not worthy of probity. There's no reason to be looking at this. But then why do they keep lying about it, Christine?
No,
that's the thing that I don't get. We don't know, to Rick's point, we don't know that the president lied about any of this to people who it matters. Those questions were written for a reason. They were lawyered up and doctored for a reason. And by the way, I don't begrudge that. It would be silly to do it any other way, certainly given the disposition towards mendacity of this particular president. He'd be foolish to have done it any other way. His initial bombast was just that. I'm going to sit down man to man with Mueller. He was never going to do it. He wouldn't even do it in civil suits, let alone something
Nor
like
should
this.
He have done it.
Well, that's up to who you are and what your disposition is and your confidence in your verity.
Right.
And clearly he didn't have it. That's okay. He did it the way most would. I wouldn't have been surprised if he would have pleaded the fifth if this came down to a subpoena contest. And then he would have felt very differently about that than, again, his bombast has suggested. But you're still left with this fundamental frustration. If there's nothing there, why would Michael Cohen lie the way he did, thinking that he was helping the president? Why would Papadopoulos lie about a meeting that should have meant nothing? Why would they come up with a stupid story about the Trump Tower meeting? Why would Michael Flynn lie about when he talked to an ambassador and when he didn't? Why, Christine?
You know, look, it's that saying we've all heard, the cover-up is often worse than the crime. And I think it's just basic logic, basic common sense, that if you haven't done anything wrong, you're completely transparent and put everything out there. But if you're worried you did something wrong or you know you did something wrong, you hide it and you try to obfuscate. That's what they're doing here over and over. And if they didn't do anything wrong, which I believe they did, they're making it a million times worse for themselves. So if there's nothing there, show your cards and tell the truth. Otherwise, you're just making more clouds and more doubt against yourself.
I mean, look, my junior counselor's mind, Rick, my concern is this. I don't think there are going to be any crimes. If I'm representing the president, I'm not worried about them bringing him illegality his way. I don't think he can. I believe the DOJ guidance on it. I haven't heard any reason to believe they asked for different DOJ guidance. I don't think they're going to do a set-aside indictment. It doesn't make any sense. Mueller's never done anything like that in his career, even just reading over his report today from the NFL about how they handled domestic violence. He doesn't do fancy, complicated. He does straight in front of him. So it's not about illegality. It's about a report that he's going to put together that could have pages and pages of a pattern of bad conduct that is beneath the level of a president. Are you worried about that, Rick, as a supporter of the president?
Well, I am worried about it. First off, just the whole idea of a report where it's a, you know, look, it's a document from, that's a one-sided document. It's from a prosecutor trying to make a point of his prosecution, whether it's an actual prosecution or indictment, I should say.
Lifelong Republican who's always served with honor and never been accused of any kind of perfidy.
My point is, I have concerns about the fact that there's going to be this one-sided report that comes out that's going to be damning. I have no doubt that it's going to be a damning report. I mean, I think it would actually be nice if they shared that report with the president and he had an opportunity to actually have a rebuttal to that when it comes out. I mean, that way, at least the story
could be... I think
they
are planning to do exactly that.
Yeah.
I hope they do that. I really do. I know that's one of the things I've heard, but it would be absolutely essential for fairness that both sides have a chance to tell
the story.
As long
as the report comes out
time.
In full. I have to go. I'm out of time. But that's an important point Rick makes. They're going to control the process. The mandate for the special counsel only assumes that when they're done, they give a report to the attorney general or the acting attorney general, the deputy attorney general at that time.
Whatever.
Who's overseeing the probe, but not to the American people. And if the president wants to put out a rebuttal, that's fine. But they better not take out any of the things in the Mueller report.
I just think it's important that and I know there's a lot of folks who are questioning the attorney general. The attorney general owes it to the president, any president, to give him the opportunity to tell his side of the story at the same time when the reports come out, not one and then the other.
And more important than the president is what he owes the American people.
Yeah,
and
no,
that's
I
a full
you.
Disclosure of what's in the report, and the attorney general or the acting or whatever
out.
Should not and cannot
unless,
hold
unless,
any of that back.
Yeah, unless there's something of national security.
No, that's what they always say. Let us determine whether or not.
I'm sorry, the media doesn't get to make that call.
Yeah, but, I know.
I don't think we're not looking at those kind of matters.
Thank God for the leaks.
I hope not.
And they'll be coming. They won't come from the Mueller side, but we know as soon as this hits the White House, we'll hear plenty. Christine, Rick, well argued, and thank you.
Thank you.
All right, you know who was taken by Trump's tweet in support of Stone? His longtime pal, Michael Caputo. He's now using it to help Stone pay his mounting legal fees. He had to answer questions from the Mueller team himself. He knows it's very expensive, and he's
the most trusted name in news.
The president is creating more legal scrutiny and certainly political scrutiny for himself after crossing a new line in his anti-Mueller tweets. He condemned his former attorney for turning on him, and then he heaped praise on a longtime advisor for having guts because he potentially says he will defy the special counsel. Critics are crying witness tampering, even obstruction of justice. Let's hear what a Trump defender and former campaign advisor Michael Caputo has to say about all of it. Welcome back to Primetime. Good to see you.
Good to see you, Chris.
Why is it okay for the president to say, if you shut your mouth, you're strong?
Well, that's not what Roger said he was going to do. He said he was not going to lie. He said he wasn't going to bear false witness against the president.
Well, who's asking
and
him
I think
to?
The president is... What's that?
Who's asking him to?
Well, I believe that we're looking at Jerry Corsi is saying that they were asking him to do that. I think people who see what's going on with Manafort now, Paul Manafort, we're going to find out soon.
But you know that Jerry Corsi, when you look through the pleadings, Jerry Corsi lied to them. I mean, you know, it's in there. You know, he'll say, well, I thought
right,
I was
Jerry
answering
Corsi
the best
is...
at the time. Yeah, that's on him. I don't know how you could not
remember
he didn't remember, you know.
I'm not here to defend Jerry Corsi. I know Jerry Corsi says that he didn't recall an email exchange.
Yeah.
You know, when you're asking somebody
you to go to
remember
Julian
something
Assange,
2 years
you pass
ago.
It along and you forget?
Listen, he forwarded an email and he didn't remember it 2 years later. I understand the inability to remember every single small thing that you did in a matter of a moment.
I know, but that wasn't
but what
a small
Roger
thing.
Stone said.
Go to Roger Stone.
What Roger Stone said is he wasn't going to bear false witness against the president. The president thought that he was being a stand-up guy. I don't see anything wrong with supporting someone who said they're going to tell the truth.
Right. I just don't think that that's what's going on here, is that it seems that what the president is saying is, I reward you as strong for refusing to participate in the probe any more than you absolutely must. And that's just a weird thing.
In fact, that's not what he said in his tweet, Chris. And that's, and that's not what Roger said in his interview.
Put the tweet up for people.
What Roger said is he's not going to bear false witness against the president.
I know, but nobody's asking him to bear false witness. They're asking him to come in and tell the truth and explain something that he has given a very twisted explanation for a long time. I will never testify against Trump. This statement was recently made by Roger Stone, essentially stating that he will not be forced by a rogue and out-of-control prosecutor to make up lies and stories about President Trump. Nice to know some people still have guts. First of all, if you want to go by the lettering of his own tweet, I'll never testify against Trump. Well, by the way, that's sometimes your duty, is to come out and testify against, about, whatever preposition you want to use, and do your duty, because you have nothing to hide. Roger Stone seems to be wanting to evade that situation, and the president is saying, good. Whereas when Michael Cohen worked with prosecutors, the man all of you used to celebrate, now he's a rat because he worked with the government. Like we're in the mob time. Well, the people that you and I hate as an insult to our ethnicity, that's now the way, the main mode the president looks at a prosecution.
Roger's not been interviewed by the Mueller investigation yet. He expects that he will be at some point. But, you know, the way the tea leaves are being read by just about everybody, including you and this show and this network, is that they're going to be asking Roger Stone to give witness that he somehow or another notified the president of something that went on with WikiLeaks. And Roger knows that he never did that. So he will not state that. If he's asked, he's not going to be the source of that kind of information, because being that source would mean that he's lying.
Nobody's asking
like
him to
Jerry Corsi was asked to lie.
But there's an assumption here that people are asking him to say things that were untrue. Who's asking him to do that?
But Joe, those of us who are in the jackpot, those of us who are in the jackpot of this thing, believe that people like Michael Cohen, for example, you have to look any further than Michael Cohen's face to understand that he's been through hell. He's decided to go ahead and say things that we don't believe are true. And Roger has said that he won't do the same thing.
He
opened in 1862. This beautiful structure behind me was
because they have corroborative evidence
in England
of what
for those with a superstitious disposition. 13 is, of course,
it's not just that they decided to take his word all of a sudden. I know that'd be convenient for guys who want to besmirch him and defend the president, but that's not what happened. There are contemporaneous communications that prove he was lying about saying was over at the same time the president was saying.
Today, a young family are being drawn back to their roots in their search for a rural idyll. And right from the off, we deliver exactly what they're after.
John's always wanted an island, so
but it doesn't stop there.
No, you found out that a president was lying.
I did not say that Michael was trying
Today, a young family are being drawn back to their roots.
That's what he was doing. He might have gotten a piece of the management of a hotel. He was just doing a deal, the same deal that he always does, selling his name.
Right.
But he just lied about
what he was doing all of his life. Chris.
He was lying about what he was doing. Go ahead.
You got to let me answer this.
Go ahead. I was just trying to make it clear. Go ahead.
He's been a builder all of his life. He was running his business as a campaign for president. And Michael Cohen, like many other people in the Trump organization, was charged with going out and trying to find deals and getting a piece of them if he succeeded.
Yes.
He wasn't succeeding. He actually rarely succeeded in these big deals. Sold a lot of apartments, got a lot of slices of apartment sales, but didn't succeed in these big deals. It was another big deal that Michael Cohen was pursuing, and the president was encouraging he and all other people who were off pursuing deals to find those deals in case he had to continue his business and did not become president.
Understood.
I don't believe that the president was intimately involved in this. I don't believe the president was involved in some kind of ridiculous idea that they were going to offer a $50 million apartment to Vladimir Putin, which is an idiotic idea that the president would never have given that kind of a spiff
away. I don't know what he did and what he didn't. I know he signed the letter of intent.
But,
I know the president says himself he's the one who decided
this,
to kill the deal.
I will tell you this, Chris. Mm-hmm. That the president of the United States, the people around him are being pursued relentlessly by the Mueller investigation. And in many ways, they're being, you know, being pushed through financial problems, financial issues. That's why I'm trying to raise money for Roger Stone today on GoFundMe. You know, being this financial punishment puts him up against the wall, tries to get them to say things that aren't true. And that's what Roger said he will not do. He will not bear false witness against the president. And I think that's a strong and positive thing to say, something that takes guts. And that's what the president said. He liked Roger's guts for saying that.
As long as people tell the truth, they'll never have a problem. And we'll see when the report
And you
comes
understand
out,
that Roger said he was going to tell the truth.
I know. I mean,
and that's
look,
what
I
the
think
president
that
was
Roger
congratulating
spun it in
him
a way
for.
That was good for him to do. He's a clever man. He's very good at this. We'll see what happens
Spin
if he goes
in
here.
Politics, Chris?
I know.
Spin
he's a master.
In politics?
He's a master.
Shocker.
He's a master. But when you dovetail it with the law, it gets tricky. Michael Caputo, thank you very much. Your perspective is valued. All right.
Thank
the
you.
NFL. We don't talk a lot about sports on this, but this isn't about sports. It's about domestic violence. You see what happened there? You see Kareem Hunt, the huge running back for the Chiefs? You see this video? One of the league's top
the house
backs,
rule.
Pushing and then
the bill.
Kicking
radiation
back
no unauthorized copy
Green Hunt no cut from the Kansas City Chiefs roster soon after the surfaced. He's apologizing now. He's got 10 months since the incident. He says he's sorry. Let's bring in D Lemon. And Don, it took the NFL a long time to respond. This tape, it's look, it's not Ray Rice. You remember that video, right? But it doesn't have to be. He's pushing people around. He winds up kicking his partner on the ground while she's on the ground. My issue is, what do you see in the league's response?
Well, for me, two things. This is actually about him more than the league, those actions. That's not the first time he's been accused of this.
Right.
It's on video. The video is horrific. There's no excuse. And
yep.
I know he's apologized. He's a young man. He's 23 years old. I mean, he's the whole, his whole career, I think, is ahead of his ruin. That's what I think.
Well, but you shouldn't no, need, you
I am a New Yorker. I'm a mom of the 100 Horror Story. Do you notice?
The hottest General Hospital.
Video, I don't care
baby.
What they look like.
Yes.
There's another woman. Whatever. Yep. It's just awful.
It's a crime.
It's terrible.
Yeah, just kicked
so there's girlfriend. No excuse. The NFL's response, I got to say, I think that the Kansas City Chiefs acted pretty quickly from what I know about.
Mm-hmm.
But the NFL did an investigation and had not spoken to the woman
nope.
or to him.
Well, they say she wouldn't talk to them. But it's clear that once again, they did what came easy, not what would be hard, which would be blowing this situation up and going after one of their own.
How did TMZ get the video and they not? And the cops couldn't get it or the NFL didn't get it. That's the thing
desire.
That I don't understand.
Yeah. Desire. Who wants it, got it. And I'll tell you what, it's worth people going online and reading Robert Mueller's report on the NFL's botched investigation of Ray Rice. Now, you're going to get two things. One, you're going to get the truth about the NFL and how they slow walk these things. And two, you're going to see how Mueller does his work.
Well,
straight, clean.
Well, we're going to talk about Robert Mueller and the president coming up in our show. I got to tell you, Chris, I was out in our, you know, in our hometown where we live. We're mm-hmm. at the, you know where Townline Barbecue is?
Sure, I do.
We're at the Townline Barbecue. Everybody at the bar was talking about this Hunt story. That's what was on everyone's mind. Obviously, it's Sunday and football's on. But that's what they were talking about, how it was terrible what he did.
Mm-hmm.
But at this young age, they said he was like number three in touchdowns. And
yeah.
he's an amazing career. Over. Gone. Awful, awful, awful for the woman and to the other two people he's accused of doing it to.
Yeah.
But also, 23 years old, his life, I think, with the NFL, I think, is over.
Touchdowns, good. Touching
yeah.
people when they don't want you to, bad.
No
D-Lemon,
excuse.
We'll be watching. Thank
See
you very much.
Bit.
All right, a short while ago, President Trump and First Lady Melania arrived to pay their respects to President George Herbert Walker Bush, now lying in state at the U.S. Capitol. It's a beautiful moment. It's a moment of respect that this country is based on. 41 was a good man. He was a uniter. And he's going to be that even after his passing. Some things I want you to remember about who